Audio check. Checking audio. Testing audio. Up. There it is. Okay, apparently some weird thing is happening. Yep, no fancy openings, no panel. Just hopping right into it, actually. It's because, you know, we switched over from the PC to the computer, because my computer kind of sucks. So, as many of you might know, I am a pilot, or student pilot, and so, of course, I'm training to become a pilot. We are playing on the Xbox, so it's more of playing with my controller than a actual flight system, but it's close enough. So we're gonna go and do some landing challenges today, I suppose. We'll go ahead and finish up the landing challenges, I guess. No, I've done a few, not really a lot of them. Oh, okay. There's only like four more, but I'm gonna go ahead and hop into it, and yeah. Now, a reminder, I am a student pilot with about 3 hours of flight time. I have not once landed or taken off, so bear with me on this, okay? Today, we're going to talk about a little bit of flight as we, you know, come into for approaches and all that good stuff. Oh, we got the Dr. Pepper, Rice Krispie Treats, marshmallows somewhere. We're set up and good to go. Alright, let's talk about what's right here now. So, it changed. I don't know how much I can talk about this. Okay, so that's our plane. Wonderful, wonderful beach craft. Oh, shit, it threw us right into it. Okay. So this is our wonderful, wonderful plane. And the airport is... Oh, that's the rudder. I guess I can't really zoom in. Oh, well. That's fine. I didn't need to zoom in anyways. Oh. Alright, look. I haven't played MSFS in a while. I don't know how to put my gear down. Let's see. Where's the trim? Pitch. That's not the right thing. Is my gear down? How do I, Aha! Okay, that's the one for it. So if we look at our instruments, we are actually coming in for a horrible, horrible landing. But that's okay. We have time to practice. It seems like we have some elevator pitch. Right about... Hi, Frog. Okay, we're too high. We're much too high. Yeah. We'll restart it. That's alright, Frog. Appreciate you coming in. Okay. Restart this. Because I messed up really badly. Feeling a little bit sick. But that's okay. So. This is LFMN. I don't exactly know where it is. I think it's somewhere in New York. Okay. So we're in a downward dive. And now we're in a upward ascension. Bye, Frog. Okay, so what we need is a little bit of pitch trim. A little bit of downward pitch trim. Not that much. That seems to do the job. which will allow our aircraft to fly nice and smoothly. And there's a side button, right? Alright, and this is actually not that bad of a landing. Oh, come on. Spoke too soon, chat. Brake on. Here we come. I think B is the brake, I don't remember. Not the best landing. Where's the... What button is the brake? Well, obviously, you know, clicking the brake would turn it on. Ah, okay. I see now. Okay. That was, not the best, but... Trying. Where are we? France. We're in France. Okay, that makes more sense now. I apologize. I'm a little congested. I can't really smell. Okay. We need down pitch of about 0.4 degrees. Start our downward descent and start rotating to the left. I really wish I could see these panels a little closer, but it's fine. Look how nice that is, chat. Look at that. Alright, landing grid void. Descend a little bit more. Nice and smooth. Landing gear down. Parking brake set. We're coming in for a very nice landing now, actually. I'm gonna go ahead and reduce throttle here. Oh, careful on the stick. Alright, and throttle is cutting throttle. Keep nose up. Touchdown. Alright, so when you're on the ground, you have to use your rudder to steer, actually. So the little rudder pedals on my controller here are my left and right. Just roll a little bit more. There we go. Okay. C again. Not very smooth landing. Roll too much. And not the best precision. But hey, I'll keep trying it. I might switch over to another landing course, but you know. Never know. Alright, chip. We ran out of Dr. Pepper. Turn my UV off. Alright, we need negative 0.4. So what the pitch trim does is it... The tail back there. It changes the elevators, and the elevators are... the left and right parts of the tail. And pretty much, they control going up and down for the aircraft. So when you change the pitch trim, what it does is it changes how much your aircraft will move. Because when you have like zero trim, it might cause your elevators to go up because of the wind resistance. So you could use your pitch trim to trim out any of that noise to allow you just, you know, fly nice and smooth. Like so. Oh, there is an autopilot. Oh, how nice. I don't know where the autopilot wants to fly us, though. Oh, that's a bank. That is a bank. Lander deployed. Brake deployed. Head and throttle. There we go, chat. Nose up, nose up. Center line. Touch. Stay on that center line. Very nice. Oh, actually not very nice. I lied. Okay. 18-foot ground roll. Not the best landing position. We'll do it one more time, and then we'll switch over to a different one. Oh my goodness. My chat, or my nose, is eating my face alive. Like, it's just congesting my nose, and I can't get it out. Alright, go away, Yoke. Yoke, go away. We need... Wrong way. -0.4. Landing gear deployed. We'll just go ahead and set the brakes out too. I'm gonna fly heading with autopilot here just for a little bit. And then we'll go ahead and just engage it. Disengage autopilot. Pull back on the throttle, the stick a little bit, and start our left turn. Very nice. Very smooth. I'm going to start cutting back on the throttle here a little bit. More altitude. Pull back on that throttle just a little bit more. Third person maybe. Ah, that looks... Actually looks like it might be harder to do the third person maybe. Water. Oh, that's water. Cut and throttle. Now we are coasting in. Oh, that's a stall. Oh, flare. Nope. Ah. Well, we'll go back to looking at. Look at the other landing challenges. Alright. We'll go into the epic category. And we'll go ahead and do a... We'll do Lukla at Nepal. Lukla is a very small runway. And it's very high up in the mountains. Alright. Looks like we need to descend... Slowly cut back on the throttle as we come in. I don't think that should be too hard. No, really, it really shouldn't be too hard to do. Alright. First things first, clear the yoke. Second thing second, see if we're descending, which we are. Mess with pitch trim a little bit. up that massive descent. That seems to do it. We're gonna go ahead and turn on autopilot here, because we got a little bit to fly before we get to our location. I could honestly just fly this in using just this, but I'm not going to. Let's see. Alright, airport's to the left. Or, sorry, to the right. Ah, I see it. I'm gonna go ahead and cut back on throttle here a little bit. Deploy landing gear. And turn on the landing gear. Oh. I guess landing gear is already out. Alright, chat. Gonna go and do full flaps. Ah, there we go. Full flaps. Oh my goodness. So what flaps do, if you didn't know, chat, flaps are used to generate a lot of lift for when you're going at a slow speed. Oh, and we're falling out of the sky. Yeah. So flaps generate lift, which is, you know, something that we need for an aircraft to fly, and allows you to fly at a slow speed. Now, flaps are used for taking off and landing at the same time, interchangeably, because you can use flaps to land. Oh. Oh no. Oh, jet, no. Oh. Okay. So that's a stall, and a stall is what happens when the aircraft either pitches up or lose so much airspeed that it can no longer fly, pretty much. I don't remember, it was like somewhere in the ones. Maybe like 1.3. I don't know what that does. Alright, anyways. Where is Lupa? Wonderful, wonderful Lupa. I can really just move around in the cabin very well in this game. And it's kind of fun. Alright, Lupa's over there to the right. Alright, full flaps. Maybe we can try a third person, I guess. Alright, so if you look on the left, at the bottom left, where it says airspeed. What we don't want to happen is we don't want our little airspeed indicator to go into the red, because that will cause us to stall. I'll show you guys the stall later, because during this flight. But pretty much it's where your airplane can no longer go up because it has been dragged back down to the ground by drag and weight, drag and gravity. Gravity can be also called weight too, but that's what we're looking at. Alright, we're going to cut back on this throttle here. Flaps up to maintain airspeed. 1/2 flap. Full flaps. I'm a little fast for this, but it's okay. Ooh! That was a bumpy. I forget that we have reverse thrusters sometimes. That landing was not pretty whatsoever.
Yeah.
Too much force. Oh, actually, no. It wasn't that bad. We'll go ahead and do it again, though. I think I can get it better. Alright. I'm gonna go ahead and press Y to fly, amazing. I need a little guy here. Ah, okay. So when using autopilot, it uses automatically trim. So, yeah, that works out. Man, I could really use some air. No, I'm joking. Maybe open the door? No, I'm joking. I'm okay. I need to actually begin this. We don't need to worry about really any of those. Alright. Lukla. Where could you? Disengaging autopilot. And descending. Parking brake is set. Half laps. A little bit harder to fly like this, I suppose, because I would be able to see my my instruments a lot better. I knew how to zoom. Ooh. Here we go, chat. Coming on in. Now, honestly, I could fly purely just with that little left instrument down there. Like, I don't even need to really check this out. I can fly us in just with this. Because this gives me an accurate look at the terrain. And it tells me my airspeed. So, we need to go full flaps. Come on, baby. Might be a little bit too high for this. We were too high. Chat, we were too high. We might have been a little bit too high. No, maybe go back to main menu. Let's see whatever other cool stuff we can do. I should have access to the Top Gun stuff, so we can do that too. Activities. Skip over flight training because we don't need it. Here it is. Yep, we got challenges and stuff. We got the F-18 trainings. Ooh, we split S-meters. That sounds fun. Okay, split S's aren't really that bad. It's where you turn the aircraft upside down and you pull until you are level with the ground again. I'll go ahead and show you. Yep, so it's not that bad. Alright. We're just gonna let this thing to the lady here. Alright, and we're gonna go ahead and do this. So we're gonna go upside down. Oh, we're gonna hit the ground, chat. Oh, we're gonna hit the ground. Woo! Okay, I guess we can pull on the stick a little bit harder. Just a little bit harder, I guess. Yeah. Very nice. And yeah, that was it. I think I have the Dark Star thing. I don't remember. I can definitely look and we can do Dark Star. Doing stuff. I don't remember where it is. It's not here. Oh, it is here. What else do you... What is this? So this is landing on the carrier, pretty much. Not pretty much, it really is. So, the F-18 has this little special thing inside of its, the tail section, where it displays a hook. Hooks onto a cable when landing on an aircraft carrier. It's really cool, really interesting, because these aircraft fly really fast, and then they hit this tail hook and it goes and hooks on. Hey Amelia, thanks for the follow. I appreciate it. I'm good. How about yourself? I apologize, you're not going to see on messages on the screen, because we're playing over on Xbox. Because my computer is a little stinky and does not like to play high-end games like this. How long have I been streaming? That's a good question. Probably around about 2 years now, I think. I get deployed. Break. Yeah, about 2 years. Reduce throttle. My favorite game? I haven't exactly come across a favorite game quite yet. I don't know, maybe Kerbal Space Program. Give me the ball. Uh-oh. That's big text. I can't look at big text right now. Hold on. Hold on, my friend. I know I'm low. It's not easy to land an F-18, okay? Wave off. Wave off, wave off. Oh, our gear wasn't even out. Oh my goodness. Hold on. Really like your streams. Is there a chance we can connect in Discord so I can be update with your new stream and get some? Yeah, I'll go and put in chat. There you go, bud. Okay, wait, hey, we didn't fail. We just merely, didn't succeed. If you know what I mean. You clearly just didn't succeed. Alright, J-Hook is out. Manager's out. We are... looks like about a mile out. Yeah, it's looking fine right now. We're at good throttle right now. Full flaps. Looking good, looking good. Reduce air throttle, airspeed. Too high. A little lower. Cut and throttle some more. Still too high. Come on. I know. Sooks, I'm not waving this off. Come on. Ball in the ball. Oh! Oh! Oof. Missed it just by a little bit. Let me just activate the it should be exactly that. Can we turn on autopilot with this? Autopilot appears to want to kill me. I'll have to get that in a second here, sorry. God, my... he's trying to just... he's trying to freaking kill me. Alright, too low. It says we're too low here. We got this. Call the ball. We got this. Looking good. Falling ball. Damn it. Almost had it. Oh, let me go and get your name. Amelia STIC. I'm guessing that's 2 underscores. Hold on, hold on, hold on. Oh my goodness. Chill out. There you go. All right. We're gonna do one more try, and then I'm gonna go get some food. Engaging autopilot. Autopilot appears to be trying to kill me again. A little to the left autopilot. Alright. Nice and easy, chat. Oh, we're not in the right direction for the aircraft carrier. I know. Bomb ball. Damn it. Full throttle. Damn. Alright, chat, hold on. I'm gonna go get some food. You guys stay here. Don't get. Alright, chat. We're back. We have received some food. And we are ready to finally take this landing. Now, it's no easy task to land on a moving carrier. I don't know if any of you really knew that. God, he's trying to kill me. What's this? Doesn't work. Sorry, I got a notification I want to look at. Alright. Coming in. Turn that off. My flaps are set to full. Back on the throttle a little bit. Harder than I thought. Hold on, let me fix it. Pull in the chat here real quick. There we go. Alright. One more time, and then we'll switch over to something else. Face down, autopilot, as I look around the cockpit. Ooh, a button. Okay, this thing, obviously I think most of you guys know what that thing is from Top Gun. That's the ejector. Don't have any idea what that is. That's landing gear. That's canopy. No idea what half these buttons are. Bingo! Oh, I can bingo things. But what bingoing means is it just allows you to shoot your fuel out. So it allows you to disperse your fuel from your fuel tanks. Can we just autopilot this the whole way in? No, we're gonna go too high. Is not that hard. Just a few things we gotta do in order to nearly get her running. So the Dark Star is an actual aircraft. I don't know how exactly real it is with how fast and go, but it is an actual aircraft. Ooh. Alright. Dark Star is ready. We're going to increase the power to full. Release the brake. Afterburner's gauge. And we don't really need to pull back. Gear's coming up. Back on the stick here a little bit. Alright, we're going to maintain a 10 degree pitch. So that's 10 degrees. At Mach 9. And we're maintaining GPS heading. Really just zoom in here, I suppose. We need to go to the right a little bit, or we're going to miss our target, but quite a lot. Oh. All right, cool. So we are currently going really high into the sky, about passing 18,000, 19,000, 20,000. Maintain a 20 degree pitch, so we need to pitch nose down a little bit. As you can see, that's the base all the way back there, quite far away. Oh. Maintain 20 degree pitch. Very nice. Now, it will get a lot more interesting here in a second. Come on, stay on 20 degrees. Oh. Nope, we're going up. There we go. Okay. Now, chat, we flip over.
Oh.
And we slowly pull down. -20. Alright, now we're gonna gradually pull back up to 10 degrees. Mach 1.3, so we're going 0.3 over the speed of sound. Going very, very fast, actually. That's about... speed of sound is 945 miles per hour. So faster than a car. And we're going almost twice that, so... really fast, really fucking fast. Okay, I'm gonna stick just a little more. Come on.
Up.
Almost hit Mach 2. 1.8. 0.8. 0.9. Mach 2. Now we just kind of wait until we get to Mach 3. Okay, so the interesting thing about this is if you go behind, hold on, making sure, okay, just want to make sure my mic's on. If you go in front of it, you can't hear anything, but once you go behind the engine, yeah, you can hear sonic booms. Okay, but anyways. Left a little there. I'm going to activate bottom beacon. Bottom beacon is ray. I can look at it. Come on. Come on. Oh, come on. Beacon off. Top beacon on. Fuel cells engaged. Yoke. Go away. Come on. Oh, come on. Scramjet. Come on. Engage. Now it's okay, so. What we're doing is we're turning off our main engine and waiting for the scramjets to warm up. There we go. There they are. So now we've activated the scramjets, which are making us go really fast. Just down to above 12,000 feet. We are not quite there yet. Engine down. $98,000, $99,000, $100,000. Oh, we can see the closed chat. Mach 8, Mach 9. Stabilizing. Stabilize. Up a little bit. There we go. Relatively stable. Relatively stable. We're having to mess with the little ups and downs. Is there trim on this? No. Alright, we're gonna reach Cape Canaveral, which isn't really that far away. I have no idea where we are though. We could probably look at the, or not. I thought maybe we could look at the map. That helps. Oh, we are off course. We need to amend this course just a little bit. Just a little bit. A little bit to the right. We're going down by about 1,000 feet per second. Still going Mach 9. Which is very surprising, honestly. Yeah, no, we're now much faster than the speed of sound. And easy. Nope, don't get stuck on the button. There we go. Nice. And that is pretty much it. Yeah, no, that's basically it. Not much other things we can do here, except for, I guess, just wait. No, granted, Cape Canaveral is definitely a little bit of a ways. But, I mean, it's not that far. It's really not that far. One second, chat. Alright. Let's get to Cape Canaveral. Looking down there, it looks like we are somewhere in the middle. Weather, race controls, camera. We can definitely engage showcase mode. Yeah. And very good chat. How far can we go? Ah, that's actually really nice. That's very pretty. Go back to cockpit. Come on. Mach 9-3. We're descending. We're quite rapidly descending, actually. How much further is Cape Canaveral? It's a little bit of ways. Not that I can actually really see where Cape Canaveral is. What is this? Oh, I can zoom. Oh, chat, we can. Oh, that. Look at that. Quite beautiful. We're just gonna mess with buttons here. At Cape Canaveral? No, I don't think so. We need to get back up to about 12,000. 97. Alright, we can push down a little bit. Trying to stabilize. 9.75. Come on, just a little faster. I really want to get Mach 10. Oh, but having to play with this little joystick definitely is not helping. Come on. Oh, great, there's a freaking motorcycle guy outside. Oh my goodness, where is Cape Canaveral? I mean, there's the frickin' moon. Oh, chat, I gotta sneeze. Uh-oh, chat. This is bad. I don't have a mute button for my Xbox controller. Easy, calm down, settle down. Come on, I know we can go just a little faster. Landing gear. Ignore landing gear because we don't need to worry about that right now. Don't worry about that. Don't worry about that, because you can't use that either. What are you? We don't want to worry about you either. What are you? That's the generator. We also don't want to worry about you. Alright, cool. Can't use you. Great. My goodness, chat, how far is Cape Canaveral? Come on. Oh, shit. Back off course again. Just gonna go ahead and use a little, Rudder friend here to try and get us back on track with Cape Canaveral, or just our GPS, I guess. Oh, that is some rudder. All right. It appears that we've massively took a massive descent after using that rudder there. But that's fine. That's honestly fine. So, where is Cape Canaveral? Interesting. Oh, we can change the brightness? No, we'll keep it on there. Slowing down just a little bit. Oh, that looks like the Mississippi. Really wish I could have a map. But I guess we're just all coasting together. Yay! How much fun. Let's take a look. This tells me nothing. There's a menu. What does the menu button do? Come on. Ooh. I don't know what all these are. Chat, look at it. That's the coast. Look, chat. That's the coast. We're almost there. We're almost there. Oh, and we're almost at Mach 10. Oh, because we're descending really fast. That's probably why we're almost at Mach 10. Nine point eight nine. No, go back to 9.9. No. Where are you going down? Oh, tells me how far it is. All right, Chad, we're almost there. Almost there. Just a little further. I do need to pull up though. We need to get back up to 12,000 feet. Alright, that's at 50 before. Dear Lord, I can't see anything. TFC, APTE. We're at Florida. We've reached Cape Canaveral, chat. Pitching down to negative 10 degrees. Where's our G? Pulling positive G's. And pulling negative G's. Reduce the idle. Come on. Throttle back. All right. Oh. Idle. That's idle. Speed below 5. Pushing down to negative 10 degrees. Descending down to 5,000. Or sorry, 50,000. Are we supposed to land? Oh shit. No, we're supposed to land. Subturbines. Scratch it off. Why is there two different throttles? There we go. Send 10,000. And other turn. Right. Cape Canaveral. Looking good, looking good, looking good. Cape Canaveral is in that general direction over there. Nice. That's the ocean, looking great. Looking good, looking good, looking great, looking grand. Passing 15. 16. 15. 14. 13. Going level off. Push down that 10. Oh, there we go. 10,000. Send the 3,000, reach the waypoint. Somewhere in the ballpark of 4,000. Oh shit. After I pulled back on the stick to go up, I was pushing down. 3,000. It's so hard just to keep this aircraft going straight and level. There's gotta be a button for trim. Instrument systems. Flight instruments. Nope. Miscellaneous. Nope. Perhaps it would be autopilot? Autopilot, hold on, would be right bumper A. That keybind seems not to work. Right bumper A. Maybe it is working. Okay, hold on. Clearly it's not that. Autopilot. Right bumper A. Right bumper B. Heading hold. Altitude hold. Right button X. Okay. It would seem like we just can't use any of the holds. We're almost there. We could have been using afterburners this whole time, and nobody told me this why. Too low. It's much too low. Come on. Still going Mach 1, which is pretty damn impressive. So this is Virginia. Or not Virginia, frickin' Florida. I think. Cape Canaveral, Florida, right? Unless it's North Carolina of the Cape. I don't really know. Keep up here a little bit. Oh, there's an airport right there. Chat, let's land at the airport. No, don't land at the airport. Good idea. Too much. Four nautical miles. Three nautical miles. Two. And one. Shit. Shit. Totally are landing. Send 18,000. Or 1,800. Establish glide path. Landing gear deployed. Reduce speed to 200 knots. Glide path established. On the runway. Just a little bit. There's 200. Nice and easy. Oh, well, we were on a glide path, but I guess not anymore. Oh, there is trim. I don't even know how to use it, though. Alright, here we go, chat. Welcome to Cape Canaveral. Lined up with runway. Darkstar 1. Clear for landing. Oh, that's a beautiful landing. Touchdown. Reducing throttle. Activating brakes. Throw in reverse, you got it. Brakes. Nice. Very nice. A good 36 minutes. Nice. That's awesome. I'm happy with that. That's nice. That's good. What else we got? I think we should do one more thing and then we'll go end it. We got access to this thing yet? No, not yet. Still downloading. Cool. What if we did? I know what we can do. Let's go ahead. Oh, excuse me. Let's go ahead and do this. Alright. We're coming in for a VHF approach, which means virtual flight rules. Or VHF. VHR. VHF. VH. No, not VHF. VFR. VFR. Virtual flight rules. Or visual. So visual flight rules, meaning like what you can see, not using your instruments.
It's a beautiful summer evening as you approach Sitka, Alaska with your flight instructor after a cross-country flight to Juneau.
Uh-huh.
Enjoy a leisurely VFR approach over some stunning terrain.
Thank you. I will. Autopilot. Thank you. Uh-huh. I don't know where this airport you speak of is, though. I don't see it on my maps here. Ah. It should be straight in front of us. Gotcha. Alright. We're just going to go ahead and maintain heading and slowly descend. Guide? No, okay. I thought there might have been a guy next to me. Get rid of the yoke. Autopilot disengaged. Pulling back on the stick here. Gonna crash in the mountains if I don't. Up. Nice and smooth. Up. Come on. Just up. A little higher. Thank you. Very nice. Alright, as far as I'm aware, I don't have any runway in sight quite yet. Oh shit. Not good. Oh, not good. Right. Okay. We're good. Thank you. Although the pitch needs to go down a little bit. Not up. Not up. Autopilot engaged. Autopilot disengaged. Gonna make a right turn here for this little approach, I guess. Oh, that is freaking beautiful. Oh, how beautiful that is. Let's take a look at the law of this over here. Okay. Turn a little bit to the right. A little bit to the left. Okay. Should now be on approach. Activate the autopilot.
Sitka's ahead of us now. I know it's a gorgeous afternoon, but we're getting pretty low on fuel, so let's head toward the airport.
Autopilot disengage. Runway in sight. Alright. We're gonna set her down. Disengage. Let's bring her down. There she is. Oh, that's beautiful. We're at looks to be 90 knots, which is would like to be a little bit slower, but that's fine. Any more GWS callouts? Just 500. Hundred, 300. Oh, that's a freaking nice view right there. Ow. Go and put flaps up. Brake engaged. It was not a nice landing. Don't you say that. Don't say that. It was a landing, not a nice one, though. Nice. Well, it took 6 minutes. Alright, chat. That concludes this. Appreciate those of you who came in and joined us. Made it to about 2 hours today. I appreciate it, and I hope you guys have a wonderful, wonderful day. Till next time.